Dear children of God, sisters and brothers in the Lord, dear servants of God, this brief meditation comes to you for the month of December 2021. I bring greetings to all of you in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, along with my dear brother Dr. James Rajasekharan, who organizes this ministry, Jesus Today Ministry, every month. We both greet you for a happy Christmas and a blessed New Year. God has been gracious to all of us to bring to this last month of 2021. We struggled a lot, but God has been gracious. We also pray for those who lost their dear ones, the bereaved families, and those who really struggled during the pandemic. And also we also pray for those who are affected by flood in Chennai, in Kanyakumari, in Kerala, and other parts of the Tamil Nadu, India, and also other parts of the world. So we pray for them as well. This brief meditation comes to you for December 2021. I would like to read Luke's Gospel, 2nd chapter, 10th and 11th verse. How does it go? But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord." So this is a Christmas message. Christmas has double sides. A double-sided Christmas. As the coin has two sides, Christmas also has two sides. One is a side of universality, and second is a side of particularity. Universal Christmas as well as particular Christmas. I will explain those two terms very briefly. First of all, it is a universal Christmas, because in 10th verse it says, a great joy for all the people. Yellarukum Natchaidi. In Tamil, it goes like this. In Ungal Yellamakkalukum, Sahala Janangalukum, Uriya Natchaidi Ungulukarivikare. So, first of all, it has a universality. Universalness of a great joy. So, it is not only for Christians, it is for the whole people of the world. So every nation should be happy, every community should be happy, because the Savior came for all the world. I'm always happy about John's Gospel 4th chapter, because it calls Jesus as the Savior of the world, not Savior of the Christians. It is the Savior of the world. So first of all, it is a Christmas for all people. Universality. Don't limit Christmas within yourself. Please transcend the borders of Christian church and go to help all those people who are outside of the Christian church, because Christmas is all people. Secondly, it is not only universality but also particularity. Particularity. What is particularity? It says in 11th verse, to you is born this day. To you. He is born for all people, but to you he is born on this day. Who were the people who were called to you? It was the oppressed, marginalized shepherds. So, Christmas is also particularized to some people who are very much oppressed and marginalized. So therefore, we need to be very careful in that as well, my dear friends. Oppressed people, marginalized people, minorities, all those who are suffering because of oppression. So we need to be thankful to God that Christmas is also particularized. It is for you. It is for all people, but it is also for you. Therefore, let me finish this brief meditation that Christmas has two sides. First of all, a universal side, all people. And secondly, it is a particularized side for some people, very, very much particularized to the oppressed people. May God bless all of us in this Christmas season. Happy Christmas and Happy New Year.